Hello guys, and welcome again to another episode of the Bola Bola's take on the UEFA Champions League Fantasy Show. My name is Elvin, part of the Bola Bola Show, and together, you know, as part of the Bola Bola Show, I have myself, Steven and Bala. You know, you want to check out our content, please do check us out at bolabola.my, and including all our social platforms available there on the links below. Do check us out, do support us. But you know, for today and as well as the previous episodes that I was doing with you guys, you know, I would really like to focus and talk about the UEFA Champions League fantasy football game, and basically how are we doing, and looking forward to really journeying with you guys in this tournament. In fact, you know, and we hope it's going to be a fantastic match day 3 coming soon. But you know, as what we did in the previous episode, we would like to, in this episode, we will basically like to go through our league, our Bola Bola league, and there's some very interesting news there, guys. And in fact, you know, we will also like to then go into the match day 2, how did we perform, and also what's our plans for match day 3. So that's going to be the show for today, and hope you guys stay, enjoy it, get some tips. Who knows, you know, while you're setting up your team, maybe you can pick some things out from us, you know, pick some bones from us. Go ahead and share it with your friends as well. So you know, if you guys have not subscribed, we really hope you can subscribe, give us a shout out, you know, share it, like, and hit the notification bell for more videos like this. We really thank you for your support, and from all the guys in the Bola Bola Show, thank you so much. And let's get into episode 3 of the match day 3 fantasy football game. Hey guys, and welcome again. So basically, this is how our Bola Bola Show Liga is going on. You know, so far we have got 21 members. Great, there are more guys who actually came on board. And you know, the league code is at the bottom, the description there, and also in the YouTube video clip description. Just copy the code, you know, join our league. The more the merrier. But so far, you know, as what I mentioned earlier, there has been some interesting news that I would really like to share. What happened in our league in match day 2, and have a look at this. I would really like to give a shout out here to Anna Bapa. Anna Bapa, you know, if you're watching this video, please do give us a shout out, send us a comment on YouTube. You know, you are on fire, man. You are on fire. Look at your match day 2 squad, 99 points there, a total of 164. You have taken the lead in our Liga. You know, congratulations to Anna Bapa and for having a fantastic match day 2. In fact, you know, let's get into Anna Bapa's squad in match day 2 and see what happened there that contributed to 99 points. That's a big haul, you know, to actually get. To me, in this fantasy game, if you can actually get, I would say, 75 to 80 points consistently on every match day, it is, you are basically there. You know, you need to have that consistency there. But you know, Anna Bapa, match day 2 really gave him that fantastic haul of 99 points. And you know, having a look at his squad, guys, let's just look at his squad. He's got 2 star players there, and of course Salah and Leroy Sané at fantastic games. Anna Bapa, you know, even though Lewandowski gave you 20 points for a 10 point haul from his captaincy, you know, if it was Salah as a captain, it would have been, oh man, you know, you would have been flying up there. But you know, I would really like to congratulate you, Anna Bapa. And in fact, your overall points of 164 ranks in the top 3,000 in the world out of about 1.25 million Anna Bapa. So basically, you know, we are so happy to have you on board. And a person in our league now is basically in the top 0.25% of the competitors who are really going all around the world. So we want to cheer you on, Anna Bapa, and the rest of the guys in our league, you know. So keep going, you know, and really wishing you luck for this match day 3, and you know, hope you saw even higher. And as for the rest of the other guys in the league as well, you know, keep pushing, keep going, you know, and we hope that, you know, you guys are really going to do well in match day 3. Yeah, so let's get into how we did in the Bola Bola Show in match day 2. Well guys, you know, for us in our Bola Bola Show team, you know, I would say, yeah, we had 60 points, but it's still not good enough. And you know, the thing is, we did better than what we did in match day 1, where we only had 51. We topped it with 60, but we were so confident, in fact, heading into this match day with Haaland. You know, but that was a real bummer of Haaland, you know, getting injured over the weekend before his game. You know, he did not participate, and the changes and all that we have made. So, you know, it really took a hit on us. It was good that actually, Ronaldo scored that last minute goal against Villarreal to actually give us a bit of boost there as we made him our captain, but, I would say, having Salah there was really a blessing for us. He really hauled in that 16 points and really helped us a lot as well. And, Santos as a defender also did fantastic there. But the rest of the guys, I would say they pretty average overall, and we can definitely do better. And this is what we're really banking on and hoping for match day three. So for match day two, 60 points, let's hope how things pans out. But we'll have to endure this in the long run. There's still many more match days to go. So let's see what our plans will be for match day three. So guys, our plan for match day three, we intend to use the two free transfers that we have before we actually decide to use the wild card or the limitless. It's not going to be this round. We decided again to just go for the two transfers, and there'll be some reshuffling that's going to happen in this match day three. It may surprise some, but we definitely have our reasons for it, and this is what we plan to do basically for match day three, right? So if I go to the transfers and I have a look at our squad here, so basically making the transfers, the first person that is going to be transferred out of our team was costing us a lot of money. Basically, people may ask, why are you doing this? Well, because it's not to say it's inconsistent, but there has been rotation happening in the squad. Of course, he will start, I think, this game against Atalanta. It's Cristiano Ronaldo. Because of that 11 million cap that he holds, because we are really interested in another striker, there is so much more, a lower value, a better value, in fact. And that's why our plan here is to release Ronaldo, which we'll see now. I'll remove him. And who are we replacing him with? So the person we are replacing him with is this guy, Karim Adeyemi, the German youngster, just 19 years of age. He's been a monster for the Salzburg team. And in a very open group, I really see this group being very open, a lot of goals. It's just non-stop action in this group, and Adeyemi already has got two. He played two games and he's got two Man of the Match awards already, right? Even though he's got two goals, he earned four penalties. Of course, that was just basically a crazy game against Seville in the first round. But he has been consistent, and why I say he's consistent is because at just being 19 years of age, he's really the forefront of the Salzburg attack. And so far this season, he has played 15 games and already scored 11 goals for Salzburg. So I really, really foresee him, even though Wolfsburg can be tough defensively, but basically just the openness of this group and the attacking prowess of Salzburg really pushing up front and being so enterprising. This guy is definitely going to bang in some points. And just looking at the value, yeah, Ronaldo may score against Atalanta, and I think maybe he will score. But the value that Adeyemi can bring when we release that cap from Ronaldo and use it for another value midfielder after this, we really believe the balance would be here. And this is what we are going for this. We are taking the gamble on Adeyemi for this, but we are confident it's going to work, and let's hope it works. All right. So basically, by selecting Adeyemi, it gives us about a 3.9 additional cap that we can spend elsewhere. And for us, that the next player that we are going to take out is basically Eric Lamela. It's not to say that he has been performing badly, but at his value, the mid-range midfielders and all that, the reason why we feel that we can do better here is because we want to spend on someone that's really consistently going to play, someone that's going to start, and someone that is playing up front, at least in the midfield role. And we did, have a few options in our head, but after having that cap that Ronaldo has released, and by us removing Lamela, we have got a 9.9 budget. It's a very high budget for a midfielder, and in fact, with that budget, I'm just going to go unlimited here. And basically, the guy that we are going to take, I'll just straight away get into the club so that you all know who am I talking about.
And the guy that we're going to take is Federico Chiesa. Forefront of the Juve attack, scored in the last game. Dybala is still struggling with injuries. So we can really foresee Chiesa to really be the man. And basically looking at him, he's got Zenit for the next two games. Yeah, Chelsea is going to be a tough one in match day five. But, you know, we believe that Chiesa can bang in some goals here. And that's why we're sticking with him for basically match day three, four. We may shuffle it up. You know, we may go limitless in the next match day. Let's see how our match day goes. Of course, this is going to be our plan, basically, for making the transfers for match day three. And we hope that, you know, you guys may get some inspiration from this. You know, of course, we're not asking you to just sell Ronaldo. You know, if you want to keep him, go ahead, keep him. You know, it's Atalanta. It's going to be another free scoring game, I suppose. Whether he's going to score more than one, we don't know. Let's see. Okay, but we really hope this goes well for us. And this is going to be our plan. As for the captaincy, basically, if we look at the dates of the games, so we are thinking on the first day, we were actually contemplating Haaland to go for, to make him the captain for the first day. It's going to be against Ajax, another open group, yeah, I would say. But Haaland is still not fully returned, and we only hear that he's going to be, he may play against Mainz this weekend. So, you know, if he plays, it's great, we can consider him. But we're going to go for the first day with Dzeko, because we feel that he can bring some value here, and it's going to be against Sheriff. And let's not underestimate Sheriff here, because we know what happened. We all of us know what happened to Real Madrid when you underestimate Sheriff, right? Because Real Madrid did not only shoot the Sheriff, they did not shoot the deputy as well. They just blew it against Sheriff. And but Inter, I think the Sheriff, you know, I may be proven wrong here, but maybe Sheriff's bubble is going to burst, and it's going to be two back-to-back games against Inter, and Dzeko is going to be, you know, the man up front, and that's why we're going to put him the captain for the first day. And for the 21st, if Dzeko doesn't do well on the first day, we have a few options here. So it could either be Chiesa. We are thinking of either Chiesa or Adeyemi. So Adeyemi against Wolfsburg and Chiesa against Zenit. We'll see, you know, we'll probably decide depending on how Dzeko performs. But basically, that's going to be our plan for match day three. So there you have it, guys. That's our take on match day three. And let us know what you think about our squad. Join our league again, you know, descriptions are all there. Get your friends on board. Let's have fun on the league. Give us suggestions, you know. Let us know if our transfers are crazy or you like them, you know. And all the best for match day three. And till we catch up again for the next video for match day four, good luck, guys. Let's roll on.